Good morning, children. Have a glance at the formula to answer any objective type questions. Chapter 12, Discrete Mathematics. Choose the best answer. Question number 1. A binary operation on a set S is a function from. We are given 4 options. Let us recall the definition of a binary operation. Binary operation star is defined for every ordered pair A, B belonging to S, S such that the answer A star B should belong to S. So from S cross S to S. From S cross S to S. So option 2 is the right choice. Question number 2. Subtraction is not a binary operation in. R set of real numbers, Z set of integers, N set of natural numbers, Q set of rational numbers. If I take N, say 2 natural numbers, 2, 3. 2, 3 are natural numbers. But what about 2 minus 3? My answer is minus 1. That does not belong to N. So we will say, difference between 2 natural numbers need not be a natural number. A natural number minus another natural number, my answer need not be a natural number. So, out of the 4 sets given, N is the right choice where subtraction is not a binary operation. Question number 3, which one of the following is a binary operation on N? A little before we said, subtraction is not a binary. One natural number minus another natural number need not be a natural number. Similarly, division is also not a binary operation. 3 by 4 is not a natural number. But multiplication, if 2 numbers are natural numbers, if I multiply, my answer is again a natural number. So, multiplication of 2 natural numbers is again a natural number. So, option B, multiplication is a binary operation on N. Question number 4, in the set R of real numbers, star is defined as follows. Which one of the following is not a binary operation on R? R is a set of real numbers. When I want to say not a binary, check which numbers do not belong to R. Square root of negative numbers. How do we write square root of negative numbers? Square root tells me whole power half. So, consider this operation where I have A power B. A is minus 4 and B is half. What is minus 4 power half? Minus 4 power half is square root of minus 4, which needs to be a complex number. My answer is plus or minus 2i, which does not belong to the set of reals. So option D is the right choice. Check the other 3 are correct. Minimum of A, B, maximum of A, B and the first element A. These all belong to R. The only option where I have powers, I must ensure fraction power for a negative number does not belong to R. So option D is the right choice. Question number 5. The operation star defined by A star B equals AB by 7 is not a binary operation on. A into B divided by 7 needs to be a fraction in some cases. In all the sets given, fraction is not allowed in Z. Fraction is not allowed in Z. So if A is 1 and B is 2, 1 into 2 by 7 does not belong to Z. So, AB by 7 need not be an integer in all the cases. Therefore, option BZ we will choose. Question number 6. In the set Q, define A dot B is A plus B plus AB. How do we understand this? The two elements given, we will add and then add the product. We need to find the value of Y for 3 star operation, Y operation 5 equals 7. Let me use this condition. 3 dot operation, Y dot 5. What is the meaning? Add the 2. Y plus 5 plus multiply the 2. Y into 5 is 5Y and this is 7. Again, there is the dot operation. What does dot mean? Add the 2. First element plus this bracket. Y plus 5 plus 5y. Plus multiply and add it. Multiply the 2. 3 into y plus 5 plus 5y equals 7. Add and then add the product. As I simplify, it is 3 plus y plus 5 plus 5y plus 3y. 3 into 5, 15. 3 into 5y, that is 15y, which is 7. Add all the y terms. Y plus 5y, 6y plus 3y, 9y plus 15y, that is 24y equals 7. Bring these terms to the right. Plus 3 goes as minus 3. Plus 5 goes as minus 5. Plus 15 goes as minus 15. So we get 24y equals minus 16. As we simplify, y is minus 16 by 24. Cancelling by 8 table, it is 2 by 3. So my answer is minus 2 by 3. So the correct option, check where you get minus 2 by 3, it is B option. So option B, that is y equals minus 2 by 3. Question number 7. If A star B is root of A square plus B square on the real numbers, then star is. We need to check commutative and associative properties. A star B given as root of A square plus B square. What about B star A? It is root of first element square plus second element square. It is only plus symbol. So A square plus B square and B square plus A square are equal. So we will say star is commutative. As we know, root of A square plus B square equals root of B square plus A square. So we can immediately declare it is commutative. What about associative? We need to take 3 elements. Change only the brackets. What is A star B? Star tells me root of A square plus B square star C. Again there is star. What does star tell me? Root of square the first element. Root A square plus B square the whole square. Plus square the second element, that is C square. Square and square root cancels. I just get A square plus B square plus C square. When I come to A star B star C. A star. What is B star C? Star is root of squares I have to add. Root of square plus square. B square plus C square. Again there is star. What does star mean? Square, square, add it. A if I square, it is A square. Root if I square, root of B square plus C square, the whole square. I get A square plus. Square root and square cancels. I'm just left with B square plus C square. Again, I can check 1 and 2. Both are equal. So we will declare star is associative. Here we have said star is commutative. So option C, both commutative and associative is the right choice. Question number 8, which one of the following statements has the truth value t? Sin x is an even function. Is it true? No, it is false. Why do we say false? Because it is odd function. Every square matrix is non-singular, need not be. If determinant A is 0, we will get singular matrix also. So this is also false. C part, the product of complex number and its conjugate. Complex number Z, conjugate Z bar, we get mod Z square, which is purely a real number. Why do we say? Mod Z square is definitely a real number. But they have given purely imaginary. So that is also false. My question is, which gets truth value T? Here all we say the truth value is F. Coming to the last section, root 5 is an irrational number. So this is true. So which gets the idea T? We say option D, where I say root 5 is an irrational number. So this is a true statement, and so the truth value is T for it. Whenever it is true, we say T, and whenever it is false, we say F. So option D gets the truth value T. Question number 9, which one of the following statements has truth value F? There are two statements given. Chennai is in India, that is true. Or, so we say or, root 2 is an integer. Root 2 is an integer is a false statement. TRF gives me T only. Chennai is in India, true. Or, root 2 is an irrational number, that is also true. TRT, again my answer is T. Chennai is in China, it is a false statement. Or, root 2 is an integer, that is also false. FRF, my answer is F. The question is, which has truth value F? So, I get F for C. So, option C is the right choice, where I get the truth value F. Question number 10, if a compound statement involves three simple statements, then the number of rows in the truth table is. How do we get the number of rows? It is 2 power number of simple statements. There are three simple statements, so my answer 2 power 3, that is 2 into 2 into 2, which is 8. So, which is giving the 8 answer? Option B. 8 is the correct choice. Question number 11. Which one is the inverse of the statement? They have given PRQ to P and Q. PRQ implies P and Q. My question is inverse. How to get inverse? Negation of PRQ to negation of P and Q. Negation of PRQ, I can write negation of P and negation of Q. De Morgan's law implies negation of P and Q, negation of P or negation of Q. Again, this is also De Morgan's law. So, my question is PRQ implies P and Q. The word inverse statement claims us to write negation of the first statement implies negation of the second statement. Negation tells me I can take negation in, R becomes and becomes R. This is De Morgan's law. So, which option gives this answer? negation P and negation Q. Here we have implies negation P or negation Q. So option D is the right answer. Question number 12. Which one is the contrapositive of the statement P R Q implies R? The question is contrapositive. What do you mean by this word contrapositive? Negation and reverse it. So this I will write first. Negation R implies negation P R Q. Negation R implies. Negation PRQ. Again we use De Morgan's law. I can take negation in. R becomes and. So which option gives this answer? Negation R implies negation P and negation Q. So option A is the right choice. Question number 13. The truth table for P and Q or negation Q is given below. We need to choose the right answer. Find out P and Q. And claims both are true. My answer is true. Any one false comes also. My answer is false. Next, we find out negation Q. How to find negation Q? It is just change T to F and F to T. So T to F. F to T. Next we need to find out P and Q or negation Q. How to find out? R symbol tells us. Even if one is true, my answer is true. So true, this is also true, but both are false. Claims us to put false. One is true, so my answer is true. So the right choice is T, T, F, T. So, out of the four options, we have TTFT as the third option. So, correct option is 3 and that is the answer. Question number 14. In the last column of the truth table, negation P or negation Q. The number of final outcomes of the truth value F. Let us create the table and check out for F. How shall we take P and Q? P is double T, double F. We will take Q as T, F, T, F. We need to find out negation Q and then P, R, negation Q and then negation of this answer. As we try to find it out, negation Q, we just change T to F, F to T. T becomes F, F becomes T, F, T. We need to find out P, R, negation Q. So these two I will check R symbol. One true comes also true. Both are false, it is false. And one true comes also, my answer is true. Now I want negation. So here, T becomes F, T becomes F, F becomes T and T becomes F. How many F values are there? The truth value F comes in 1, 2, 3 places. So how many outcomes are there? 3 Fs are there. So the right option we choose C where 3 is the right answer. Question number 15. Which one of the following is incorrect for any two propositions P and Q? Negation P R Q, negation P and negation Q. So De Morgan's law, so this is correct. Negation P and Q, negation P or negation Q, this is also correct. Propositions P and Q, here R, here also R. So this is wrong. Negation and negation, double negation, negation gets cancelled. So this is also right. My question is incorrect. So out of the four, option C, negation P R Q is equivalent to negation P or negation Q is incorrect. So my question is choosing the incorrect one. Option C is the incorrect one. Question number 16. The dual of negation P or Q or P or P and negation R. How shall we get dual? Dual claims R symbol I change as and symbol I change as R. So how shall I write the answer? Wherever R comes, negation P no change. R becomes and. R becomes and. P, R becomes and becomes R. The remaining letters and negation symbols, there is no change. So as I check, negation P and Q. So these two, three are correct in that. And P and. So these two, P R, negation R. So here you get exactly the answer. So the correct option we call D. Question number 17. Given a table, we need to choose the correct option for P and Q implies negation P. Let us try to work out P and Q. And symbol claims both are true, it is true. All the remaining we just write false. Negation P. T becomes F, F becomes T in P. So T becomes F, T becomes F, F becomes T, F becomes T. When I want implies, I remember the word tough. T, F comes, my answer is F. T, F comes, my answer is F. Somewhat to remember the code word tough. All the remaining combinations will be true. So, out of the given choice, option 2 is the right answer. Where I get F triple T. So, that is the right choice. Question number 18, the proposition P and negation P or Q. We need to choose out of the four the right option. We can also write this as P and negation P, P and Q. So how do I write it? P and negation P or P and Q. P and negation P is nothing but contradiction. Remember, P and negation P. I can write contradiction or P and Q. Along with contradiction, if I have R symbol, I just write this answer itself, P and Q. So my right option is C. So the given statement is logically equivalent to P and Q. So option C is the right choice. Another way, you can also try truth table and find out the answer. We will take P as TTFF, Q as TFTF. I want to find out negation P. Changing T to F, I get F, F, T, T. Find out negation P or Q. Negation P or Q. I get R symbol. One T comes also. It is T only. Now I want P and negation P or Q. P and this. So double T comes alone. It is T. Otherwise, it is false. As I check this answer, this is nothing but P and Q answer. Because I know P and Q only gives me. And symbol gives me. Both are true. My answer is true. All the other cases, it is false. So these two are logically equivalent. Call this as number one. Call this as number two. 1 logically equivalent to 2 And so, the right option is C. So, you can either use truth table and find out the answer, or you can directly write the logically equivalent statements. Question number 19. Determine the truth value of each of the following statements. 4 plus 2 equals 5. That is false. And 6 plus 3 equals 9. That is true. F and T gives us F only. Second option. 3 plus 2 equals 5. That is true. And 6 plus 1 equals 7. That is also true. T and T. My answer is T. 4 plus 5 equals 9. That is true. And 1 plus 2 equals 4. That is false. T and F. My answer is F. 3 plus 2 equals 5. That is true. And 4 plus 7 equals 11. That is also true. T and T. My answer is T. So what is my answer? FT, FT. Out of the four choice, FT, FT comes here. So option 1 is the right answer. Question number 20. Which one of the following is not true? Negation of a negation. So we have negation of a negation is P. So first statement is true. If the last column contains only T, then it is a tautology. This is also a true statement. If the last column of the truth table contains only F, then it is a contradiction. This is also true. If P and Q are any two statements, P double implication Q is a tautology. Biconditional statement is not a tautology, so this is false. My question is not true. Out of the four, option D is not true. So option D is the right choice. You can also try using truth tables. Here are some more formula from our textbook based on binary operation, where it is and where it is not. About the number system. About the commutative property, associative property, existence of identity, existence of inverse, and about Boolean matrices, the operations join, meet, and the various laws, closure, associative, commutative, and identity inverse for the operations join and meet. Addition modulo and multiplication modulo operations. Additive identity and multiplicative identity. Regarding truth tables, we ought to know the AND, OR, NOT, conjunction, disjunction, conditional, biconditional statements. We also need to know the converse, inverse, contrapositive of the given statement and certain different operations like EOR, the exclusive OR statement. From the truth table, how to determine tautology, contradiction, contingency and dual of a statement. From the truth tables, how to identify logical equivalence and the laws of equivalence, idempotent, commutative, associative, distributive, identity, complement and De Morgan's laws, also absorption law. It's good to learn these formula. All the best.